Hello, hello everyone. I am thrilled beyond measure to welcome you here to the beautiful historic Royce Hall. My name is Eileen Strempel and I'm the inaugural dean of the Herb Alpert School of Music, and it is my honor and pleasure to welcome you here this evening. Tonight's concert is a celebration. We celebrate first and foremost our students. Could we even fit one more instrument on the stage tonight? I don't think so. Look at those. Our students are our greatest treasure. They're our present, and more importantly, they are our future. They come to UCLA for top-notch professional training to create and to hone their craft working alongside some of the world's best artists. But here tonight, they will show you that they are the artistic leaders of our future. And I couldn't be more proud and excited to hear them tonight. Christian Gonzalez, the wonderful concertmaster tonight, I will have you know. Thank you for tuning everyone up. Christian is actually playing one of the school's Stradivariuses this evening, so I want you all to know that you are hearing a Stradivarius being played tonight. And we don't hoard. We don't hoard. It's not just the star faculty at UCLA that play the Strad. The best, we are not holding back. It's for the students, because again, they are the future. So tonight again, we celebrate. We're coming together as a community to hear live music, and after 2 years of COVID, my goodness, I promise never to take that for granted ever again. It's just sheer joy. And we celebrate cross-cultural connections. This concert tonight really epitomizes the future of music. It's the power of music to connect across the globe. We've got Brooklyn, we've got Mexico, we've got Los Angeles. It's all together here, people. This is it. Awesome. This is the future of music right here in Los Angeles at UCLA. And tonight we also celebrate some of the greatest musicians and public intellectuals in the world. It is rare to have on the same stage the truly legendary Mariachi Los Camperos, led by Jesús Guzmán, UCLA organist Christoph Bull, our own UCLA Philharmonica, directed by Neal Stulberg, and our UCLA Afro-Latin Jazz Band Orchestra, directed by Arturo O'Farrill. Arturo O'Farrill, my dear love. Love you, Arturo. And the pièce de résistance, the iconic, the incomparable, Cornel West. So, we are all certainly in for a sublime evening of music. Thank you again for being here with us and sharing with what I know will be an extraordinary evening of celebration. This is UCLA music. This is 21st century music making. And I would like to now invite you to enjoy the show, and I will introduce to you, as my great honor, Steve Loza, who's the Chair of Global Jazz Studies and Professor of Ethnomusicology. Steve.
Thank you, Dean Strempel. My goodness, did you hear that? Welcome, bienvenidos a todos. I want to start off by just recognizing our sponsors, because without these agencies at UCLA, we wouldn't be here tonight, and it's important. I want to especially thank the staff, the technical staff, the student staff, the faculty, Kathleen Hood, who I don't even know if she's still alive. But you know, I've been teaching here for 36 years and I've never seen the folks work this hard on a project. And I think it's because we brought our students together tonight. You know, this is an unprecedented unifying of our Philharmonia, our Afro-Latin Jazz Orchestra, not to mention the other things that you're going to see tonight, that represent our school and our faculty and our students. So welcome. We want to thank the UCLA Center for Latino Arts, the UC Regents Lectureship, the UCLA Chancellor Arts Initiative, the UCLA Herb Albert School of Music Lecture Fund, Eileen Strempel Dean, the Arturo O'Farrill UCLA Research Fund, Global Jazz Studies here at UCLA, the Division of Social Sciences, Daryl Darnell Hunt Dean, the Friends of Jazz at UCLA, Gloria Turner, President, Terrence Blanchard, holder of the Kenny Burrell Endowed Chair in Global Jazz Studies. Yeah, all right, what's going on there? All right. Robin D.G. Kelly, who is the holder of the Gary Nash Endowed Chair in History. These are all people who decided to chip in from their own funds, foundations, etc. The Department of African American Studies, Cheryl Keyes, Chair. Yes. Wow. And the Bunch Center for African American Studies, Kelly Lytle Hernandez, Director. I'm going to do a little reading here because I don't want to forget anything. I usually like to, in the words of my friend Arturo and Dr. West, I like to riff. I like to do my improvisation. But I don't want to forget some of the things that I have to say. And I'm going to try to do this quick because we want to get to the music. Tonight we celebrate 40 years of working with our brothers and sisters in Mexican institutions in the areas of music performance, research, and teaching. Throughout this time, we at UCLA have sent our students, instructors, and scholars to present their work and perform for their counterparts, especially at the National Center for the Arts in Mexico City. All in all, we have produced over 100 interchanges or related events during the past 40 years. Tonight was planned as a celebration of UCLA, Los Angeles, and Mexico through the art of music. We originally planned for tonight to happen 3 years ago, but due to the COVID-19 crisis, we had to postpone the project twice. Tonight, we have finally arrived, more motivated more than ever, and with an artistic and cultural hunger to return to the music, the purpose of the project. An additional opportunity came our way to expand the vision of tonight's concert. Professor Arturo O'Farrill, whom we brought here 3 years ago, at the same time we brought Terrence Blanchard, had recorded an album titled Four Questions, featuring the artistic and socially powerful oratory of the internationally acclaimed Dr. Cornel West. Yes, let's hear it for that man. Dr. West is a thinker who fits into tonight's theme, as his ideas represent the concept of beyond borders and global reach and understanding. Four Questions was awarded a Grammy last year. I was trying to read some of my notes here that I can't read, you know, so. But yeah, it was awarded a Grammy last year. The album that Dr. West collaborated on with Professor O'Farrill on, representing an artistic and cultural feat. And such recognition and performance projects often go unheralded today in today's society. But this recording and composition made and makes a difference in the areas of culture, race relations, and social change. So we decided to invite Dr. West to perform the piece with us here at UCLA in, as I said, this unprecedented unifying of our Philharmonia and the Afro-Latin Jazz Orchestra. So we invited him to come and present his thoughts and ideas on music as a UC Regents Lecture, one of the highest honors we bestow here at UCLA, and he's been doing this throughout this past week. In fact, this past Wednesday, he gave a powerfully and timely principal lecture with the title, The Musical Vocation in Our Bleak Times. Wow, not bad. So we welcome Dr. West and his essential message with open arms and minds. May God and the universe bless him always. Another piece composed by Professor O'Farrill is his A Still Small Voice. based on Hindu, Buddhist, and Judeo-Christian texts. We have with here tonight to perform with all of this ensemble up here, the Los Angeles-based vocal ensemble Tonality, with its artistic director and conductor, Alexander Blake. We also will hear a rich and spiritually invoked arrangement by Professor James Newton, who is a professor emeritus, and he's here tonight. And I urge you all to come next Friday night to Schoenberg Hall, where we will be doing a tribute concert to his music. Please come. It's also free to the public. Tonight, we also celebrate various master composers in the history of Mexican music. We open with a classic Sinfonía India, composed by Carlos Chávez in 1935. We present it tonight with the original concept of Chávez's first performances of the piece, using a battery of ancient and contemporary indigenous instruments from Mexico. And we thank Christopher Garcia for the use of his instruments and his instruction. Also included in tonight's program is a very unique piece, as far as I know, never performed in Los Angeles, of the Mexican composer Miguel Bernal Jiménez, his concertino for organ and orchestra, performed by our own UCLA faculty, Christoph Bull. And finally, the Los Angeles-based Mariachi Los Camperos. Yes, sí, señor, por favor. Considered to be one of the world's most accomplished, in fact, it's right up there with the top two, both in Mexico and globally, and directed by another one of our School of Music faculty members, Mr. Jesús Guzmán, who directs our student mariachi in the program and department in ethnomusicology. The ensemble will be performing two arrangements of music from Mexico. Again, in this case, both of these arrangements with the UCLA Philharmonia under the direction of Professor Neal Stulberg. And the first is a potpourri of boleros composed by the prolific Maria Grever. And the second is an imaginative mix of Huasteco forms originating in Southeast Mexico. Many of you will recognize a classic Serenata Huasteca composed by the immortal José Alfredo Jiménez. As we celebrate the coming together of people, let us take in these musical offerings tonight that represent the crossing of cultures and the mixing of ideas. And in the words of Brother West, let us live and love as one human race. Adelante.
Thank you. de perla, labios de rubí. Mi sufrimiento, mi horrible padecer, fingiendo una existencia siempre llena de dicha y de encontrar a un alma como la mía, cuántas cosas secretas le contaría, un alma que al mirarle siempre sin nada, pero dígese todo con la mirada. Con suave aliento, que al besar me sintiese lo que yo siento. Y a veces me pregunto qué pasaría si yo encontrara un alma como ventana pa' que sepas que te quiero. Tú a mí no me quieres nada, pero yo por ti me muero. Dicen que ya ando muy errado, que despierte de mi sueño, pero si han equivocado, porque yo he de ser tu dueño. Seguirte, necesito una fortuna que debo bajar del cielo, las estrellas y la luna. Yo no bajaré la luna ni las estrellas tampoco, y aunque no tenga fortuna me querrás poquito a poco. ¿Qué voy a hacer?
Malagueña. So I've been asked to say a few words about this piece, and this piece is called Four Questions. It's based on the four questions that W.E.B. Du Bois poses in his book, The Souls of Black Folk. And what can I tell you? I created this piece after watching Dr. West give a speech in Riverside Church. I literally saw color swirling above his head. He began to take on the shape of a tenor saxophone. This is not to belittle the profundity of what he says. What he does is call all of us into account. He holds our feet to the fire, but the incredible thing about it is he does so with love. That's who I want to be. That's the kind of person I want to be. And when you know a prophet when you want to be just like them. And so we just delighted. We've had kind of a mini residency with Dr. West. And every one of us, every one of our lives has been transformed by this experience. Please help me to welcome the one and only Dr. Cornel West.
space. Royce Hall after Josiah Royce, the greatest philosopher to come out of California. And these magnificent students of all colors, look how beautiful they are. Oh, yeah. All colors, all genders, all sexual orientations, all religious identities, all national affiliations, wrestling with what it means to be human and modern and, yes, new world. Everything to do with the genius of this brother, Arturo O'Farrill, in writing this magnificent music, my dear brother and genius and giant. Everything to do with my dear brother, the conductor par excellence, brother Neal Stulberg, indeed. And then we thank Sister Eileen and our leadership as dean. We thank brother Stephen Losa, who brought us all together. And here you all are to do what? To let this music saturate your soul in such a way that you leave here so fortified you can't help but be a force for good. In the language of John Coltrane, who talked about a love supreme. Yeah. Kick it in already, kick it in already. Wow. Woo! Yes, that's St. John Coltrane. He comes out of a great tradition of a great people, of a black people, a world historical people who transformed the sonic and cultural styles of the 20th century, not because of skin pigmentation, because of spiritual formation, ethical cultivation, discipline, cultivated talent, unbelievable energy, the willingness to open themselves and bear witness to what? Yes, what the best of UCLA is about, which is what? A quest for truth. And the condition of truth is to allow suffering to speak. It can be in the barrio, it can be in the hood, it can be in poor white communities. It could be women wrestling with domestic violence. It could be our precious gay brothers and lesbian sisters and non-binary. It can be people of color. It's about the humanity. That's what the music is about. Taking us to the dark roots of our scream. In the language of the great Garcia Lorca and the celestial heights of our silence. And oh, we need it so badly today. Given the deep decay in the American Empire, all of the hedonism and narcissism and rugged, ragged individualism, the callousness, the indifference, can the music open our minds and hearts and souls so that we accept the best of what it is to be human, the best of the species, the best of UCLA. Oh, my brother, Zane is blowing. Zane is blowing. Fundamental questions to ask as a love letter to the younger generation. And the first question is, what does integrity do in the face of oppression? I said integrity. I didn't say cupidity. I didn't say love of money. I didn't say love of worldly possessions. I said integrity. I didn't teeth. I didn't say selling your soul for a mess of pottage where everything is for sale. Everybody is for sale. No integrity, like the great Jane Austen's constancy, or Malcolm X's sincerity and moral consistency, cutting radically against the grain. Mingus's face. Put a smile on Reggie Workman's face, brother. You know what I'm talking about. Yeah, yeah. Indeed. Listen, look at him. Got that vibrato. That vibrato working. Thing. Because love of truth is bigger than each and every one of us. No one of us have a possession of truth. We're in quest of it. This love of beauty, Rilke reminds us, beauty is the first touch of terror that we can steal bare. Beauty and terror go hand in hand. For terrorized people, do we have the courage to quest for freedom, or do we come to terrorize back? Thank God black people never formed a black version of the Ku Klux Klan. It would have been a civil war every generation. Civil strife every generation. America would have gone fascist a long time ago. Thank you for Martin Luther King Jr. Thank you for Cesar Chavez. Thank you for Dorothy Day. Thank you for Rabbi Abraham Joshua Heschel. All a part of a love train that focused on the least of these. Echoes of the 25th chapter of Matthew. The wretched of the earth that Franz Fanon talked about. Precious, priceless. That's Du Bois's first question. Integrity, intellectual integrity like Socrates. Moral integrity like St. Francis of Assisi. Artistic integrity like Virginia Woolf or Toni Morris or Sherry Maraga.
Manipulated by milk toast.
most neoliberal politicians are outright neo-fascist ones. Yes, the music keeps us in track of the humanity, but we can engage politically, engage morally, engage spiritually in a spirit of what? Revolutionary humility, subversive piety, acknowledging the sources of good in our lives, beginning with our mamas and daddies, and beginning with our families and communities. We are who we are because somebody loved us. We are who we are because somebody cared for us. How do you pass on that tradition? That's part of the education that our dear brother Josiah Royce has in the words at the very top of this space. Not just tools to use that's indispensable, but moral and spiritual lens through which we look at the world, to be in the world but not of it, to be over against the worst, to accent the best inside of us. Thank God for the beautiful music to help us keep alive the tradition of not just the musicians who are the vanguard of the species, because at their best, they enact a vision, a hope, a courage, a compassion. That's why the great Shelley says poets are the unacknowledged legislators of the world. They use their imagination to authorize a better reality. They use their empathy to get us to identify with others who are suffering, and then they courageously engage. Yes, indeed. So we can keep track of the best of any civilization. Grand ideal and the crime. Honesty. But it begins with ourselves. The greed in us, the hatred in us, the fear in us, the hypocrisy in us. No one is pure or pristine. No one is free of spot or wrinkle. The music humbles each and every one of us to come to terms with that terrifying question of what does it really mean to be a featherless, two-legged, linguistically conscious creature born between yearning feces. That's who we are. Headed to the culinary delight of terrestrial worm one day. Some of us have already lost so many precious ones. So many priceless ones. And it's so nice to hear that piano. Woo! Where is that piano? Where is, oh, that's, now, oh my God. Brother, we got a giant and a genius. We got two of them here. No. This is Terrence Blanchard, the first black man to compose an opera for Metropolitan Opera, the first black man to put together all the magnificent soundtracks for a genius named Spike Lee, and then got his own jazz history. You look at him, and what do you see? Oh, listen to him blow. Listen to him blow. Oh, Lord. Legacy of Louis Armstrong. Clifford, 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 Clifford Brown. Oh, Miles, Miles, Miles Davis is in there. Oh, what a rich legacy you build on. He's got his own voice, but his voice bounces off against the voices who came before. Roy Ellis, Clark Terry, Donald Byrd, Lee Martin. Oh, he got me weeping, you got me weeping. Oh, Lord. Same love tradition. He's a love warrior. He's a freedom fighter. He's a joy spreader. He's a wounded healer. In the same tradition, yes. Love of terror. So much honesty. Woo! brother, 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 man. Oh, love you, brother. Woo! Our brother Sam. Echoes of the third question. What does decency do in the face of insults, attacks? When you're crucified, character assassination, literal assassination, misunderstood, misconstrued, marginalized, pushed to the periphery. Blow, Brother Sam. Were you there when they crucified my love? Sometimes does it make you tremble and shiver? Does it make you shake? Does it give you existential vertigo? Yes, blow, Brother Sam. Were you there when Emmett Till's body was dropped in the Tallahatchie River and they fetched it out and his mother brought his body back to Robert Temple Church of God in Christ on the west side of Chicago? What did his mother say to the world when his head was there five times the size of his ordinary head? Mama Till, what you got to say to the world? I don't have a minute to hate. I will pursue justice for the rest of my life. What goes into that kind of spirit? What goes into that kind of courage? What goes into that kind of compassion? What goes into that kind of vision? She didn't do it all by herself. Came out of the genius of Hebrew scripture, spread that hesed, spread that steadfast love, spread that loving kindness to the orphan and widow. It came out of a focus of a particular Jew named Jesus. Kenosis, emptying oneself. Donating oneself, giving oneself, sacrificing oneself. That the love of something bigger than you is not just a brand, it's a cause, it's something you live and die for. That's what this